my game of the year is probably going to be The Last of Us 2, not because it was necessarily the absolute best game of the year, but because of the discussion and the talk around what it tried.
What in the blue Abbeyzilla is a joystick award? I don't know, but after all, this is the game where Senator Abby Strong gets rammed from behind with no courtesy spear. And yes, I apologize for bringing that memory up once again, but people, we are trying to hit 50,000 subscribers by the end of the year. I think we can do it because all of you are savages and I love every last one of y'all. So if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button, but more importantly, ring my notification bell, baby. Pressing all notifications is literally the only way to get past YouTube censorship. Now, anyway, I am in a good mood, people. I don't know if you can tell, but finally, our boy Neil can take home his shiny award and show his wife and her boyfriend. But the thing is, they still can't sell a single copy now, can they? The masterpiece is currently over 50% off. There are people literally reverse shoplifting this garbage. It's that bad. It went from the fastest selling game to the most returned game ever. When millions of people all across the world were sneaking back into their local stores, trying to give their copy of this woke dumpster fire back. Where is the award for the game that couldn't sell even during a global pandemic? When everyone is stuck at home with nothing to do? But it wouldn't surprise me if Skyrim Alexa was outselling this trash, because if you don't remember, The Last of Us 2 sales dropped 80% after week one. That is absolutely embarrassing. And while that was happening, Ghost of Tsushima was sold out everywhere because people vote with their money, the only thing that matters. However, to give credit where credit is due, PGA Jolin 1 was an outstanding, defining game in a genre full of golfing games and will forever be remembered as the moment where golfing was allowed to tell dark and more mature stories. Okay, look, joking aside, 5.7 on Metacritic, 2.9 on Google, I think that the community and the consumer can tell them where to stick that joystick. But we must talk about these elitist, farcical, circle jerk awards that only cater to people within the industry and not the average consumer or fan. To these absolute weirdos, everything is worth sacrificing in the name of identity politics. Imagine this winning over genre-defining Doom Eternal or Ghosts of Tsushima. And just like that, another industry proven rotten and corrupted. To all of my viewers, I know most of you already do this, but just pick whatever game or movie the quote critics hate, and you will never ever be disappointed. Let me ask some of you this: what makes a critic any more professional than the average hardcore gamer? Nothing. The only thing that separates us is that they're crooked and easily bored. Now, in this speech Neil Druckmann gave, he said he put his heart and soul into The Last of Us 2. Now, let me translate that for my viewers. What he means is he put most of his employees in the hospital with mental breakdowns due to exhaustion. These geniuses gave Naughty Dog the Golden Soy Stick Studio Award of the Year. Did they not read how much Naughty Dog crunched their employees? Just openly admitting and rewarding vicious crunch time. If that doesn't tell you they were bought off, nothing will. They Laugh at Us Part 2 Jolin 1 Edition was such a masterpiece that 3 out of the 4 developers quit over horrible working conditions. But the one upside of having such a monumentally gargantuan fuck up of a game game with such a high production value, as The Last of Us 2 being nominated so heavily on multiple publications, is that now you can use it as a spotlight on who not to listen to anymore. Oh, and before I forget, there was an award for outstanding contribution which they gave it to. Wait for it, the gaming industry. That is some next level circle jerk. It's literally the meme of Obama giving himself a medal. A bunch of weirdo SJWs patting themselves on the back, nothing more. And on that bombshell, thank you all for watching. Mannix out.